This is the YGTV News with Georgina White.
Welcome to the YGTV News. These are the main headlines today on Friday the 14th of December. I'm Georgina White. Foreign Office insists London-Spain meeting avoided bilateral talks. Chief Minister opens Gibraltar Savings Bank extension. UK MP insists Spanish Navy incursions are an act of war. Cross-party dispute over loss in RGP confidence arises. And finally, local author publishes book on Victorian Gibraltar. Following yesterday's report in the Spanish media, claiming that a meeting was held between Minister for Europe David Lidington and Spanish government officials to discuss the marine environment in British Gibraltar territorial waters, the UK Foreign Office has released a statement noting that a meeting indeed was held in London, but no bilateral issues were discussed. The FCO confirmed that the UK's policy on Gibraltar has not changed and this position has been fully respected. The UK government is always clear about its long-standing position on sovereignty, the trilateral process and the constitutional responsibilities of both the UK and Gibraltar governments. This morning saw the official opening of the Gibraltar Savings Bank extension. Today also marks the bank's 130th anniversary. During an extremely well-attended reception, Chief Minister Fabian Picardo unveiled a plaque in the lobby of the bank, officially launching the business. The Chief Minister claimed that the GSB serves as an opportunity for Gibraltar to show just how different our economic performance is from the rest of the EU. Also speaking at the event, Mr. Bossano stated that he has no doubt in his mind that the bank would provide the service that the business community requires. The bank will contribute to economic growth by providing a service to businesses as well as individuals. UK MP Bob Stewart this week explained that the British government needed to respond to the Spanish Navy incursions in a robust manner. Reports in The Independent noted that the former army colonel insisted these incursions were illegal and the UK government needed to do something about it. Speaking in the House of Commons, Mr. Stewart reminded fellow MPs that these illegal incursions are actually an act of war. He called for the Foreign Minister to make an urgent statement and respond robustly to the aggravation. In response to the opposition's latest press statement on the public losing confidence in the RGP, due to the lack of arrests regarding the fishing dispute and illegal incursions into British Gibraltar territorial waters, the government has noted that the document is so inherently self-contradictory that it shows up the many political flaws they present to the community. Regarding the claim that the police need to abstain for their assets to carry out their duties, the government statement explained that they had invested massively in maritime resources for the RGP, including the acquiring of 2 fast interceptor launchers and 2 larger vessels. And finally, Gibraltarian author M.G. Sanchez recently published a new book entitled Georgian and Victorian Gibraltar, Extraordinary Eyewitness Accounts. The book focuses on various aspects of Gibraltarian social history, with the aim of offering the reader a glimpse of what life back then was really like. Divided into 12 sections, the story includes documents on housing, sanitation, alcoholism, smuggling, religion, prostitution, medicine, employment, relations with Spain, as well as other areas of the era. That's the YGTV News. We're back on Monday. Have a great weekend.